Man, add this one to the list of things that I didn't think we'd actually be talking about in the 2021 Canucks season. So our previous video on the channel went over the idea of a Jake Virtanen trade because it was mentioned on Sportsnet, and they had a whole segment talking about whether or not the Canucks could, would, or should trade him in order to send a spark to the team. But on the most recent article published by Patrick Johnston on The Province, what we have here is a little bit of an update as to somebody else that might actually be on the block. Take a look at this. This is the article over here. It is the skate exegesis. And the part that I'm referring to in this article is probably just a few scrolls down. It's the trade bait side of things. By the way, link in the description to this full article. It's a very nice piece talking about different aspects of this Vancouver Canucks team and the makeup of it. Take a look at this right here. Jake Virtanen's lone goal, you recall, was a floated shot well from the outside that changed direction before getting to the crease. It was the ultimate luck goal. Virtanen has skated in 11 games this season and he has 17 shots in all of them, but other than a couple of spurts, we wouldn't really know it. We certainly wouldn't know he'd signed a new 2-year deal in the offseason. The Vancouver Canucks have floated Virtanen's name on the trade market, but there hasn't been a taker. Hard to imagine what might change. Adam Gaudette is also on the block, but similarly, given his poor play, there does not seem to be interest. And that is interesting. You know, I didn't really think the Canucks would be bold enough to go out there and shop Gaudette too. It's kind of funny, because in my opinion, Gaudette and Virtanen are in such different realms, just in the way that I perceive these guys and their development and what they mean to the team. Because Jake Virtanen was always in this kind of, let's just say, more difficult spot than Gaudette. Mostly because Virtanen was a top pick at the 2014 draft. We took him over guys like Nylander, Nikolai Ehlers, David Pasternak. I guess we took two guys over Pasternak, McCann as well. Oh boy. But Jake Virtanen was always supposed to be a guy who became better than what he is right now. And for Adam Gaudette, he wasn't really having that same level of hype in his entire U20 career, pretty much. Because if you remember, Gaudette was a 5th-round pick in 2015. Remember Rafael Diaz? Yeah, that guy. When the Canucks traded Rafael Diaz, they got a 5th-round pick back from the New York Rangers, which was in turn used to select Gaudette. And as time passed by, he became better and better with the NCAA, the Northeastern University Huskies. He won the Hobie Baker. His final year in college was the same year that Elias Pettersson was out here tearing up the SHL, and Besser was the Rookie of the Year for Vancouver, and they got Quinn Hughes in the draft. That was the year where Adam Gaudette kind of exploded as a prospect that was actually legit and not just your average 5th-round guy. So now that he's actually here on the team, it's funny how, given a few circumstances where he has been very nice, just wasn't able to bury any of the chances. Remember that Calgary game where Gaudette got like 2 or 3 grade A scoring chances in the first and he didn't score on any of them? Yeah, it's really weird to me how he is on the block of all people. Maybe if they're actually trying to get value out there, there's a conversation to be had with Gaudette. But Virtanen as well, he is apparently on the block too. It's just the Canucks haven't had any interest for either. So let me know in the comments what you thought about this quick update. It would be enjoyed. This was Josh Rose 99. And bye.